Hello and welcome. My name is Daria Volkova, and this channel helps you utilize Grafana to its full potential. Today, the spotlight is on a dynamic text plugin. Initially developed by one of the best Grafanistas, it has been under Volkov Lab supervision for 10 months now. With astonishing 8,000 daily downloads, something tells me the community finds it helpful. I'm sure this video will be valuable as well. I'm about to highlight all the main features and go over astonishing use cases to explain why this plugin is so popular. Are you ready? Let's go! In short, this plugin brings HTML design, handlebars capabilities, and JavaScript functions into Grafana. Here I have data on vacation rental properties in a table format. And here is what a dashboard might look like for a property manager. Every unit has its card with crucial information emphasized. For instance, whether or not guests left for the day, indicating housekeeping can start. Or if the unit requires attention, with details below. What type of attention is that? In edit mode, the panel has this content text area option. It is where you specify your design using HTML or handlebars and reference data from your data source. For instance, I connected PostgreSQL on the left, selected name from the rentals table, and then in the content, I referenced the name by surrounding it with double curly brackets. The following text area is for JavaScript. For my dashboard, I added code to hide the comments area and switch between appropriate images. As of this moment, some JavaScript doesn't work in edit mode. This brings me to the point that testing on the dashboard is better than in edit mode. We don't have information on whether this will ever be fixed. You can register your helper by using the Handlebars register helper function. For instance, here I register my helper with the name range with no parameters. It fetches the current Grafana time range. There are some built-in helpers, in other words, helpers that have been already predefined for the panel. To get the complete list, open the documentation on our website, helper section. For example, this EQ helper mimics the equal sign. In my rental properties dashboard, I use it to make my dashboard dynamic. If the guests are still inside the property, show yes in red. If no, show no in green. A note about disable sanitize HTML Grafana setting. This configuration determines whether HTML sanitizing is on or off. By default, it's on, which disable actions like onClick for a button. Make sure to set it to true if you need all actionable HTML elements and JavaScript to work. Auto-scroll example. With JavaScript code, you can make your data scroll automatically. The code snippet for that functionality is in our documentation. The next option at your disposal is the CSS text area. I have styling for table, button, and header 1 HTML elements. This schema depicts the essence of the dynamic text plugin. You have the content with handlebars, HTML, and markdown. JavaScript area describes action. CSS styling is applied after all that. And the final look and functionality depend on the sanitizing setting. In the recent release of the dynamic text plugin, we added external resources section. Now you can reference as many external JavaScript and CSS files as required. In my example, I referenced the Cloudflare library to fetch the icon of royal status to display next to the maximum number of allowed guests. You can go as far as adding the whole external library. To demonstrate, I'm thrilled to share an example with Plotly library created by one of the community members. Thank you, Joshua Solomon, for this clever solution. You can find it on GitHub, Volkov Labs, volkovlabs.io, issues, 3D, scatterplot. So the steps are as follows. Create a dynamic text panel, add an external library, Plotly version 2.24.1, keep content empty, and in the default content, add a div element with ID. The author used Addis Ababa. And then this code should go into the JavaScript code area. And then if I click apply, here is what I got on my dashboard. The Plotly is right in front of your eyes in the dynamic text Grafana panel. Quite astounding, right? Remember that I disabled HTML sanitizing in my Grafana for external libraries to work. The next feature worth mentioning is mermaid diagrams. You can describe your flow charts using this specific notation and get data flow schema like in this example. However, please be aware, we did not make mermaid diagrams as part of the Dynamic Text plugin core due to the size increase. If you need the mermaid extension, download it from our GitHub repository and install it manually. Here in the Dynamic Text section, you can find the Render Template option. In my Render Property example, I have every row selected. Every row means that the code from the content parameter applies to every row of your data. Let me switch to another visualization. Here I have a similar SQL, but I selected all rows for the Render Template option. In that event, Grafana passes all my data source data as one array. In the content text area, I can use the handler each. Data is the array's name containing data fetched from my data source. And all records of name, address, and guest columns I displayed like one body of information, not as separate pieces. Moving to the next feature, Grafana Threshold. As you know, it's standard for all Grafana plugins. For my example, I use Grafana Random Walk Data. Here is for any other plugin, I map integer value to a color. Above, I specify which data field from my data source contains the integer indicator. And then in the content area, I want to see time and a series data points. I surround the A series with the span tag and specify the background color as status color. And here in my visualization, I have dynamic highlights where background colors change according to the threshold rule. Dynamic text panel and Grafana event bus. Not all of the people heard of the Grafana event bus. It's mainly needed when you want your panels on the dashboard to interact with each other. For instance, when a user selects something on one panel, the other panel reacts accordingly. The most utilized approach for creating bundled panels is using dashboard variables, and the Grafana bus is the other solution. It is a collection of events like hover, for instance, which you can subscribe your panel to and define the actions it should take in case of the event. We compiled a list of such events. You can find it in our free Grafana crash course. The dynamic text supports Grafana bus. Let me show you a straightforward example. On this dashboard, I created two time series visualizations. In the dashboard setting, General Panel option, I specified Shared Crosshair. With that option, when I hover over one panel, I have the same crossed line on the other panel, helping me to see what value I have on the second visualization at the selected time on the first visualization. Next, I create a new visualization, select dynamic text. In the default content, I create element B with ID event origin to show the origin value and element PRE with ID event value to show the payload. Then add this JavaScript here where I subscribe to the Grafana data hover event and reassign the value for event origin element and event value element. Remember to unsubscribe to avoid memory leaks. The data source is unrelated in my example. Now if I go back to my dashboard and hover over the time series, my dynamic text reacts to that event and displays the relevant values. Grafana bus is useful, yet not well-documented feature. Should I create a video about it? There's so much to talk about. Let me know. We recently added this big thanks button, another way for you to show your support. It should be helpful for all of you who offered to buy us coffee. Now you have a simple way of doing so. The next feature is using Grafana dashboard variables in the dynamic text panel CSS section. To demonstrate, I added this margin variable. When I enter, let's say 20, the margin here changes accordingly. Under the hood, it looks like this. The margin is equal to the variable value, the date time picker. We came across this use case on the Grafana community forum. I will leave the link down below. The person with the username Orosolido shared an incredible example of using the dynamic text panel to create a stylish date time picker. Feel free to take a closer look. It is a fascinating and valuable example to bring your style up a notch. Another impressive use case is with stylish tabs. You can find a solution at Volkov Labs GitHub, then Dynamic Text Panel, Issues Closed, number 154. So I copy the content, insert it into my Grafana content, copy the JavaScript and insert it into my Grafana, and then copy CSS into my Grafana. Try it out. Thank you, LZL19971215, for this idea and the provided code. We'll love when the community comes up with elegant solutions and expands Grafana even further than we could imagine. Please send us more of that, and we will find a way to share it with the world to be amazed. It is all for now. Thank you for watching, and see you next time.